learning to trust other practitioners that aren't in the same field that I'm in. I'm full-blooded Native American, so I follow our teachings, and I don't follow anything else. So you won't find any other deities or statues in my house. So when I first came here, it was a little, I wasn't really sure. You know, I knew that Aria wanted to come from a universal perspective and to make everybody feel welcome. And so that's really what I took from, you know, all the statues and symbols and a mixture of religions that was here. And so I really had to learn to trust my gut and trust my heart, trusting Aria, trusting this container and trusting the people that were in it, trusting myself, and letting the life hacks or the codes that I have found as far as connecting, letting people in on those things. In my culture, there's a lot of medicine societies that believe that we shouldn't be sharing a lot of these things with white people. And I had numerous people warn me about coming here and collaborating with someone that follows so many different paths and religions. But when I came here, I saw that it was more to make people feel welcome and that she follows one path herself. It's not mine, but it's hers, and her faith is real. And so I just kept that, you know, in my heart going into the situation. So definitely trust and faith. She has a really gentle yet fierce way of leading. She does a really good job of keeping people on subject, keeping people in the flow of where our conversations are trying to go, and not, you know, meandering off. And being that she's such a small-framed person, I didn't expect such a fierce leader. But she does it gently, though. It's not blunt. It's just in a good way. She does it in a good way. Investing in yourself is one of the most important things you can do in this lifetime. And you can't help anybody else, and you can't pour from an empty cup. So it's important that you take the time to do the inner work. And sometimes that requires other people, and it requires a mirror so you can see where you might be deficient or where you could use a little support. And the way that these seminars are held and that she provides some kind of body work or sound work between each session, massage, combined with the emotional verbal work that we're doing, I think it's the complete mind-body-soul connection. And you can't have completeness without all three of those. And that she provides such a variety of different classes, along with, you know, creative classes, songwriting classes, movement and dance class, along with trauma, how to deal with trauma, how to reorient yourself after trauma. I think it's just the right combination so that real healing can begin. And from what I've seen, you know, I've seen people here do a complete 180 within a year. You know, the people that I met here, completely different. They've just taken the tools and applied them to their lives, and to watch that happen is just another miracle. An overwhelming sense of togetherness and connection. Sometimes during some of our sessions, I would break down from just the joy and the healing that I witnessed would just produce this ball of light in my chest that just swells to a point where it bursts and I just cry because of the joy that I'm able to witness this kind of healing in another person. And the fact that I can witness it in more than one person at a time. You know, there would be times when we were here with 8, 10 people. And so to watch someone change that much in just a weekend.